concentrated and toxic smell had taken over the place. I could observe Geronimo, how his unblinking shiny eyes were following the movement of the silhouettes. Every student was either locked up, unable to move, or both. The school had turned into his refuge. This was a slaughterhouse, a gift from father to son. I reached for the light switch. The bulbs turned on. Reflections of blood started to flicker. Tens of kids were revealed, hanging upside down like animals, their skin torn off. Some limbs twisted, other parts missing. They were his classmates, reduced as objects, things he used to play with, skinning, cutting, and tearing off their skin. Each scream of pain and each plea fascinated him. They were toys, desperately begging for the forgiveness of a mind rotted by hate. No one could ever know how truly regretful they had been. No one could have foreseen that death could be something they longed for. Forget the voices coming from everyone's thoughts. I was on the outskirts of the ruined village. In the distance, the mansion of the Tauruses lay over a meadow that contrasted with the arid land of the surrounding suburbs. It was as if I'd found an oasis.
Thank you. Thank you.